Hi, welcome back to Camp Canine. This isn't going to be a full garden tour. It's been a bit of a tough couple of, probably a week. We've had a lot of rain here, and thanks to all of the people with their words of support and praise as I coped with the flooding around my land and around my boats, which is, if you hadn't noticed already, what I plant in. There we go. So it basically looked like they were sitting in water after the torrential downpours that we had recently. I'm sorry, I just have to stroke somebody. Hello. He's just come in and said hello. Good boy, Simba. Hey? Oh, right, okay. So, other than flooding, what has been going on? Well, we've had a lot of growth in some areas, not so much in others. So, anybody that's been following my posts on Facebook and YouTube will know that I am struggling with my cucumbers. Really, really struggling. I mean, they are not growing at all. They weren't always so blocked from the light by these radishes and things. These have grown up since. I've got nasturtium there that I didn't think was going to make it either, and some petunias that have grown quite huge. I've got some sweet peas that have sprouted through that I didn't think were going to come through, and the petunias have started to flower, which is beautiful. But yeah, the cucumber here, there's a cucumber plant there, barely anything on it. I'm sure, yep, there we go. There's another one there and there. But they went in that size and they're still that size. They're just not growing. So this bed here, I've now taken out all of the radishes. We've harvested and eaten those, and I've given a lot of them away because I couldn't, our oven is broken. So I can't roast anything in the oven at the moment. So we're a little bit limited with our cooking. So a lot of my radishes went to friends. but this is all now ready to plant. It's got my aubergine and my peppers, and there's meant to be cucumbers there. But they're not germinating, or at least they weren't germinating. So fingers crossed I haven't killed the ones that have just come through. Okay, let's have a look at boat number one. I can't remember if this is boat number one or boat number two, but never mind, this one. It's right behind us, right here. So we have some tomatoes that are growing. This is my voluntary tomato plant that somehow managed to survive the winter. I have no idea how it managed to survive the winter. I was just going through my pots and things, and I had a pot that had, I don't know, was it, could have been mustard, I'm not quite sure. It had something in it that was growing, and I wasn't sure whether it was going to survive outside the whole winter. So in January, late December, January, I think it was between Christmas and New Year maybe, I brought it inside and just plonked it in the corner of the conservatory and didn't think another thing of it. Then started to have a look at it in January and saw that there was a tomato plant in there that had clearly been in there all the time, but I had paid no attention to whatsoever. So I took it out and I split it up and I put it into pots and rooted it, kept the original one as well, and this bunch along this side here are all from that, and I think that's probably why they've come out with their tomatoes first of all. They're just way ahead of the others, and I'm assuming that They are a cherry tomato. I have been very bad, whoops, at my at my pruning of my tomatoes. I think I need to give this one a bit of TLC. Wow, this is my slicer. I didn't think he was doing anything, and he's now bushing out, so I'm really pleased with that. These are my little yellows. There's a few flowers on there. The plants aren't too big. This was my hundreds and thousands, but I'm not quite sure what's going on with them. Some of my additional spring onions that I planted. I read somewhere, or I heard somewhere, I saw somewhere, that onions are great at keeping the pests away. Onions and basil, something else, can't remember what the other thing was. They've got high smell scents, and they can disguise the other plants that you're trying to protect from the aphids, etc., etc. So I've basically been planting spring onions in every little space I can find. So in this boat here, I have basil planted all the way along here, although some of it has been eaten. There, this one's going, this one's gone, but this one's still with us, going, still with us. So, and the lobelia is coming up lovely. Something's been eating this. I don't know why I put this squash in here. No, squash or no, courgette. I don't know why I put it in there, but something's been eating it away anyway. And my coriander bolted, but it's got pretty little white flowers on it. And who am I to complain about this? I love having the flowers in with the vegetables. It just makes it all that more pretty. So yeah, so that's that boat. And then on this boat here, we've got the tomatoes again. I really need to do some pruning. Those are my little white ones. Those are my little yellow ones. We've got a bit more success along here with our basil. Down here, we planted some broccoli. I planted some broccoli and it's done nothing. These tiny weeny little seedlings are what I transplanted. And this was lavendula that I put in here. It smells gorgeous. And this is, oh, what is this? It's one of the flowers. I'm really not very good with the flowers, I have to say. I don't know what most of them are called. So melons, let's talk melons. Melons not working. We've got some melons that have recently germinated in the greenhouse / conservatory that I think are going to have to come out, because these are looking pretty poor. These two here, which have got some new growth on them, I transplanted them, and I don't think I should have done that. They were already pretty much that long, and they are not looking great, I have to say. These, this was one here, and here were my watermelons, and they're just absolutely nothing. And here, I've got a melon growing here, and this one's just gone. I don't know if it was the storm. They weren't coping very well. I don't think it was warm enough for them. So they weren't coping very well before the storm, and then the storm has pretty much washed them out. So they're not looking too good, which is a shame. I've got some more of these stones here that I'm collecting this week. And if so, I can finish this side, which I'm really looking forward to doing. Can't wait until it's both matching, and then I can focus on the path that goes between. What else have I got? Oh my God! You have just got to look at this. I am so impressed with this. Now, I've never grown squash before. I've done courgette, zucchini. I've done those, but I've never done squash before. And I transplanted, and you're not really meant to. And I can understand why. And why would you? They seem to grow quite well themselves. So I had transplanted all the way down here, and these are doing pretty well. I thought they were on their way out a couple of times, but nope, they're doing pretty well. This one, I have never seen. Clearly loves this position. We've got a load of flowers on there. I'm not quite sure how many of those are male and female. We've got some really wonderfully strong stems on here. Beautiful leaves. It is sending out some tendrils. It hasn't. Oh yes, it has. It started to climb onto here. I don't know if you can see that. Can you see that? So yeah, I mean, it's amazing. It is. Oh look, we have our first squash growing on there. The question is, will it make it to adulthood? But these ones as well, this is not powdery mildew, this is just a discoloration. I'm not quite sure, maybe they're meant to be that color. Unfortunately, looks like we had a bad pollination. Not a very healthy little plant there, which is a shame. It was gonna come off. No more. I can't see any more on there, but there are some more flowers on there. We had a first run of flowers on these, first of all, and I thought, oh my God, how am I gonna cope? They've barely been planted out. They're gonna die. And then the flowers all died, and the plants looked like they were gonna die. And then all of a sudden, everything started coming back to life again. So we have some honeyboat squash here. That last one was the Japanese one. Kuchi something, can't remember. It'll come back to me. We've got some, I think these are yellow courgettes, not doing very well at all, and being eaten by something. So I doubt they're going to survive very well at all. But hopefully we've got enough planted, possibly elsewhere. There is a little, I think it's being eaten. There's another one there. Little pumpkins. I'm gonna have to. Oh, there's another one here. This one here, this vine, this has grown. I'm really impressed with this. If you look down the run, it has come all the way up onto the top of the fence. So it's doing really well, that one. I'm amazed, because I didn't think these were going to do very well at all. Anyway, so they're doing well. What else have we got? We've got our very. Oh, can you see me with that light? Hold on a second. Bertie, it's me, darling. Hold on just one moment. Sorry about that. We have a couple of guest dogs, and they didn't know who I was crouched in the garden. He's doing it again. He's sticking his head through the cat flap and going, danger, danger, danger. It's like, no, it's not danger. It's just me. It's just me. Anyway, where were we? This zucchini plant down here, we have our very first zucchini growing there. It's a tiny little baby. But aren't we so proud when the first ones come through? Oh, and there's another one. Oh, do you know what? This was one of my backup plants. I can't remember what it was a backup for now. I think it might have been these ones here that really aren't doing very well, and I can't transplant them now. It's pointless me transplanting them, because they just don't like their roots being played around with. Now, I get my dog food, raw dog food, delivered in these polystyrene boxes, and they're such a waste. They really are. They don't go in recycling. They go in the normal rubbish. I feel really guilty and really bad for using them and having them. And I try to reuse them for various different things where possible, because we do sell the raw food to our clients and the daycare. So they get moved on when we're delivering goods. But I didn't know what else to do with them. So if you have any ideas, any tips of how to reuse these polystyrene boxes, then please do tell me. I would much rather upcycle them into something else. But what I think I might be upcycling them to is going to be plant pots, because they really did keep the roots warm. There's not much I can do about, I can't move the plants out of there at the moment without disturbing them so much that I think if they survived, they'd be pretty unhappy. So I'm just going to leave that in there now. But maybe next year it's an idea. We'll see. Right, where was I? So we're going to have a look at our other courgette and zucchini plants, because I don't think we'll be looking at them for very much longer. They might spring back. I might be lucky. We haven't really had any lovely hot weather yet. They got transplanted out. They were quite a bit bigger than they are now. They've deteriorated in the colder weather and the wet weather. They're now looking very sorry for themselves. So we've got three plants in here and three plants in this one here. And they're all looking pretty sad for themselves. So I might be growing more squash than zucchini this year. Hey ho. We always have those, what is it? The gardener's roller coaster or something like that. I'm not quite sure what you call it, but it doesn't always go to plan every single year, does it? I just have to show you these blueberries in this low light. The sun's dipping down now and they just look glorious. They really do. And the rest of my fruit trees, the cherries had an early June drop due to a load of black aphids, but I think we've got the aphids under control now. There are some nice fresh looking cherries on the cherry tree. The plum is coming along. It had a lot of shock. It suffered a lot of shock from being replanted when I bought it. The fig is up here. It's stable. I think we might have some new growth on it there. Can you see that? You might be lucky. It may have settled in its pot. So those are my fruit trees. Oh, and this is my little, I still haven't planted it up properly, but my little kiwi fruit. I'm so looking forward to having that properly growing. I moved my potatoes because my dogs kept trying to get into the garden and I needed some way of stopping them. They weren't initially interested. Once the fence came down and the plants were all quite, well, busy growing up, they had no interest in getting in. And then all of a sudden, one of my in, Honey, who you can see over there, she discovered that I had the wood chips that I put in there and that they made a very comfortable and warm bed that she was really enjoying lying on. And she would jump over my raised beds in order to get into the garden. I think she was responsible for squashing a couple of the squashes or zucchinis, and she definitely was the one that took out my cucamelon. Did you remember that story from before? Bit of a highlight on that later on. So anyway, I decided to move potatoes to either side to try and block it off It's not really worked. She's still squeezed through. So, never mind. We'll get there. We'll figure it out along the way. I'm not too worried. She hasn't destroyed anything yet. Onions, wow. They're coming along really well. So, this week I had my first proper harvest meal from the garden, and I had some, I picked some of the onions, and we had them as spring onions. They're looking really good. They smell divine. Carrots, I did thin out the carrots, and then honey also came and sat in them. So they're looking a little squished. I have been picking peas all week. There's not a huge amount of them, but they do probably provide maybe 5 a day at the moment, and that's enough to give me a little snack, and I'm thoroughly enjoying it. Just have a look at these beautiful blooms. I'm just not exactly sure how I'm going to reach them when they turn into peas, but I'll get there. Okay, we have some squash. This is a yellow bird. It doesn't look a huge plant, but it has got a couple of little ones on it. And sunflowers are suffering with something. I am going to have to take care of them. They were growing quite quickly and they've slowed down. And my beetroot suffering again. And some aphids got, I thought they took out, it's easier if I do this from the other side. So, bear with me a minute. Right, we're the other side now. This is much easier. So, everything's kind of growing up along here, but this wonderful tasting spinach decided it was going to bolt, and then got taken out by aphids, but I seem to have some new growth on there, so who knows. We've had some lettuce, but the lettuce again is bolting. I bought this lovely spinach, tree spinach, at the Ardingly show. It's meant to grow about 3 meters tall. Not exactly sure how I'm gonna reach that. But I thought if I put it here, it might, if I back up a bit, if it fills out and grows up here, it might stop the dog from jumping through that area. That's what I'm hoping anyway. Isn't it a beautiful light underneath the willow tree? Let me just take you back a bit. Here we go. I love being under the willow tree. So beautiful. Sorry, head floating. Makes me very uncomfortable when I'm down here. Much better up here. Okay. Onto the centre bed. Okay, so we're now in the centre bed. I don't know if you can see, so... I don't think you can make sense of it, but that is where the willow tree is and my first run of arches. And then the bed comes down, the middle centre beds come down here, and then we have our second bent trellises, the outside bed there, and there's our apple tree and the rest of the garden that we've been in a minute ago. Does that make sense? Does it really need to? So we have more peas growing up here. They do grow so tall. It's amazing. And look, these squashes are really climbing up the trellis, and they're producing, if I can just keep the ants off of them, it's amazing. Oh, so exciting. I love it. Silly, I am so silly. So what else have we got coming down here? We have our some of our cauliflowers are getting rather large. Some of them are remaining small. And our radishes, I don't know what it is about the radishes in this. I've just got to get out of the centre bed. Oh. I don't know what it is about the radishes in this section, but compared with my other section, they are tiny and they're hardly growing. So I'm not quite sure what's in the ground. I might have to have a closer look and see. I was just kind of leaving them to it. It's very easy to just leave them to it. They're very good at growing themselves. Just tweak them here and there. I haven't needed a tweak this squash though. This squash here has quite happily grown its way up the trellis so far. This is my first time, as you know, growing squash, but also attempting a trellis of this shape. So I'm really impressed with how they're coping with the growing. Oh, what, look, can you see the beauty of the, I don't know if you can see that. Can you see those peas? I'm really not sure if you can capture that on camera. They look absolutely gorgeous. I'm looking to see if I can see any peas on here to eat. But I was only out here about an hour ago, so there aren't any on here. Oh look, we have a little baby. We have a little baby squash. And my beans. Okay, so my peas doing really well. Again, I'm not quite sure why they're growing so well on that trellis and not so well on this trellis. Sorry, that doesn't... Can you see that? So... One trellis is growing really well and the other trellis is really quite low still. So I'm not quite sure why that is, but I thought my beans were just, they just hadn't germinated, they hadn't grown at all. I had transplanted a couple and the, oh wow, I thought the slugs had got them all. Look at this one. It started down here. And it's come all the way up here. And all the way up here. And all the way up here. And it's right up here. Can you see it? Oh my God. The others, I've got one that's not doing too badly here. Okay, this one's growing up. It's growing up to about here. That's good. But most of the others, I can't even see them. Look, there's one there. Poor little thing. I mean, they're not really coming to much at all. I've not grown beans before, so. What I really wanted to do was grow the noodle beans, but I didn't know how I could get them. Here's one of the beans, and this one's grown up to here, so it's not doing too badly. So I may have some, but then look, this one has just got two little leaves on it. So maybe that's a late germinator. I did put some beans into the ground. That's Honey. I did put some beans into the ground after I had planted everything else up because I saw the others being eaten and I thought I'll try a direct sow and see. But nothing else has come up. None of the direct sows have come up. I think something's in there and eating them.